All right, today on The Explainer, we're going to tackle a question that's right at the heart of investing. So yeah, how much is a company's stock really worth? It sounds super complicated, right? But what if I told you there's a powerful way to get an answer by focusing on the one thing a stock is supposed to give you as an owner, and that's cash. Okay, so let's get right into it. This is called the dividend discount model, or DDM for short. And the big idea here is actually pretty simple. When you buy a stock, its real value is basically the sum of all the future cash it's ever going to pay you in dividends. But, and this is a big but, it's not just about adding them up. We have to account for the time value of money. You know, the simple fact that a dollar today is worth more than a dollar you get a year from now. A really good way to think about this is to compare it to a bond. You know how a bond's value is all about the future interest payments it's going to make? Well, the DDM does the exact same thing, but for stocks. We just swap out interest payments for dividend payments. At the end of the day, it's all about figuring out what a future stream of cash is worth today. Okay, to really wrap our heads around this, we're going to start with the most basic version possible. Let's call it the forever dividend model. This is going to be our building block. So I want you to imagine a company. It's super stable, super predictable, and it promises to pay you a $5 dividend per share every single year, forever, like clockwork. Now, to figure out what that's worth, we need one more number. It's called the discount rate, which is basically the return you demand for taking on this kind of investment risk. Let's just say, for this example, it's 10%.
So what you've got is this endless stream of $5 payments, starting a year from now and going on forever. The big question is, what is that whole thing worth you, right here, right now? What's the fair price to pay for that promise?
Now you might be thinking, do I have to add up an infinite number of payments? And thankfully, the answer is no. There's actually a surprisingly simple formula for this. It's called a perpetuity. All you do is take the annual dividend and divide it by that discount rate. So let's just plug in our numbers. We've got our $5 dividend, and we divide it by our 10% discount rate, which is 0.10, and boom, that gives us $50. According to this super simple model, that's the true value of the stock today. Easy, right? All right, let's do a quick little brain teaser here. What if things were a bit different? What if that first $5 payment wasn't a year away? What if it was showing up in your account tomorrow? How does that change the price you'd be willing to pay? Well, it's actually pretty straightforward. That first $5 you get tomorrow, you don't have to discount it at all because you have it now. It's already at its present value. So you just take that $5 and add it to the $50 value of all the rest of the payments, which means the stock is now worth $55. See how that works? Okay, that forever dividend was a great way to get started. But let's be real. Most companies don't just stay the same forever. They want to grow, right? Their profits grow, and hopefully their dividends grow too. So let's make our model a little more realistic and add in the idea of constant growth. So this slide really shows the big leap we're taking. We're going from a flat, fixed dividend to one that grows at a steady, constant rate forever. We're just adding one new piece to the puzzle, but trust me, this one variable, growth, is an absolute game changer. And this brings us to the famous Gordon growth model. The formula should look kind of familiar, but you'll see that new letter in there, G, for growth. And look where it is. It's in the denominator subtracting from our discount rate. That's a huge deal, because making the denominator smaller makes the final stock price bigger. So let's just make sure we're clear on what's what. D1 is super important. That's not the dividend that was just paid. It's the dividend we expect to get next year. K is the same as before, our required return. And G is that constant growth rate we've been talking about. All right, let's put this into action with a real example. Let's say a stock just paid an $8 dividend. That's D0. We expect it to grow by 5% a year. And our required return, K, is 16%. Okay, step one, we need D1, next year's dividend. So we take today's $8 and grow it by 5%. That gets us to $8.40. Step two, we calculate that bottom part of the formula, K minus G. So 16% minus 5% gives us 11%. And finally, step three, we just divide step one by step two. And the price we get is $76.36. Now think about that. Just adding that little 5% growth assumption made the stock's value jump way up. That's the incredible power of compounding growth in action. Even a small percentage makes a massive difference over the long run. Okay, now we're going to do something really cool. We're going to flip this whole model on its head. Instead of trying to calculate what the price should be, we're going to take the price the market is already giving us and use it to do a little financial detective work. Can we do it? You bet we can. If we know what the stock is trading for right now, what its dividend is, and what its growth is expected to be, we can just rearrange the formula to solve for the one thing we don't know, K. And what that K tells us is the return that the market itself is expecting to get from this stock. It's pretty powerful stuff. So let's grab some numbers. Say a stock is currently trading at $128 a share. We look it up and see it just paid a $12 dividend, and the consensus forecast is for 3% growth going forward. The key thing here is, these are all real numbers we can find. The only mystery is K. So we set up our formula just like before, only this time we already know the price. It's 128. We calculate D1, which is the $12 dividend plus 3% growth, so that's 1236. We know G is 3%. The only thing left to find is K. All it takes is a little bit of algebra to rearrange the equation and solve for it. And when we do the math, we get an answer for K, 12.66%. So what exactly is this number telling us? It's the market's implied return. It means that all the buyers and sellers out there with their collective wisdom or madness are acting in a way that implies they expect a 12.66% annual return from this stock, given its current price and growth. And that's such a crucial takeaway. The DDM isn't just a calculator for finding a fair price. You can use it in reverse to peer into the market's mindset and see what kind of expectations are already baked into the stock's price tag. Now that brings us to a really important final question. What about companies that don't pay any dividends? Is their stock worthless according to this model? And the answer is, of course not. It just means this particular tool isn't the right one for that specific job. For those high growth companies, you'd have to look at other things like their future earnings or free cash flow. But for any company that does pay a regular dividend, you now have this incredibly powerful framework to help you look past all the daily noise and ask that fundamental question, what is this stock really worth? You ever see a stock price just go wild over what seems like, I don't know, a tiny piece of news? A small shift in expectations causes this massive swing, and you're just sitting there scratching your head like, how did that happen? Well, believe it or not, there's a surprisingly simple formula that actually explains this, and we're going to break it all down. Okay, so look at this. This is the whole puzzle right here. Think about it. A tiny, tiny nudge in a company's expected growth, just 1.8%, sends its stock price rocketing up by what, almost 35%? It doesn't seem to add up, right? I mean, it feels like financial wizardry, doesn't it? So yeah, the big question on everyone's mind is, how is that even possible? How can one little number have such a huge, crazy impact on what a company is worth? Well, spoiler alert, it's not magic. The answer is actually hiding inside a really powerful tool that people use all the time for stock valuation. And that tool, that key to the whole mystery, is the Gordon Growth Model. This is what's going to help us finally understand the logic behind that massive price jump. Okay, so here it is. Don't let the letter scare you. Basically, what it's saying is a company's total value is just next year's profit divided by a super simple little subtraction, K minus G. It's a really neat, elegant way to guess what a company's worth based on all the money it's going to make in the future. All right, let's zoom in on those two letters in the denominator, K and G, because they're the most important ones. K is what we call the cost of capital. The easiest way to think about it is it's the bare minimum return investors want for their money, you know, to make taking the risk worthwhile. And then there's G. That's the growth rate. And this isn't just next year's growth. It's this idea that a company's profits are going to grow at this rate forever and ever. Yeah, forever. Okay, so theory's one thing, but let's make this real. Let's actually plug in some numbers. We're going to walk through this whole thing step by step to figure out a starting value for a company using this exact model. All right, here's what we're working with. So imagine a company. It's making 28 million shekels before tax. The tax man takes 25%. Investors, they want a 12% return for their troubles. That's our K. And for now, let's just assume its profits are going to grow at a nice, steady 5% forever. That's our G. Okay, step one. Easy peasy. We got to figure out the top part of that fraction, the after-tax profit. So we take our 28 million, we chop off 25% for taxes, and what's left? A nice, clean 21 million shekels. That is our numerator. Done. Okay, now for the bottom part of the fraction, the real engine of this thing, K minus G. So that's our 12% minus our 5%, which equals
7.07, 7%. And right here, this is where the magic starts to happen. Keep an eye on this little number, 0.07, because everything, and I mean everything, hinges on this.
So, you ready? Time for the big reveal. We take our $21 million in profit, and we divide it by that tiny little 0.07. And, boom, the model spits out a number. The total value of this company, 300 million shekels. Just like that. Now, 300 million is a huge number, but that's for the whole company. As an investor, you and I, we care about the price for just one single share. So how do we get from that big number down to the price of one share?
It's actually super simple. Just one more division. We take that 300 million and we just divide it by how many shares are out there. In our case, it's about, just under 46 million shares.
And what do we get? Our calculated share price, our starting point, is 6.54 shekels. All right, burn that number into your brain. 6.54. Because now we're going to introduce a little twist.
All right, this is where it gets really interesting. What happens if we just get a little more optimistic? If our expectations change just a tiny bit? Let's see what that does to the final price.
I want you to really get this. We are changing only one number. That's it. Nothing else. We're just going to bump up that growth rate, the G, from 5% to 6.8%. That's it. A 1.8% change. Everything else stays exactly the same. And look at this. This is the engine room of the whole operation. That denominator, the K minus G, it gets smaller. It shrinks. Remember before it was 0.07? Now with our new growth rate, it's 0.052. And if you remember anything from math class, you know what happens when you divide by a smaller number, right? You get a much, much bigger answer.
So let's run the calculation one more time. We've still got our 21 million in profit on top, but now we divide it by that new, tinier denominator, 0.052. And the result? Wow, the company's value isn't just a little higher. It has exploded. It's now worth over 403 million shekels.
And when we do that final step, divide by the same number of shares, our new share price is 8.80 shekels. I mean, that is a huge jump from where we started at 6.54.
Okay, so we've seen the math, we've seen the numbers, but now let's connect the dots. We know what happened, but we need to really understand why. Like, what is it about this model that creates such an incredibly powerful effect?
This chart just says it all, doesn't it? I mean, just look at the difference in scale here. On one side, you have this tiny little bar, a 1.8% change in our guess about the future. And on the other, a massive, towering bar, representing a nearly 35% jump in the stock price. It's just an incredible, incredible demonstration of leverage.
And this quote, this really gets right to the heart of the matter, because this model isn't just looking at next quarter. It's trying to figure out the value of growth that goes on forever. So any little change to that forever number has a massive, immediate impact on the stock's value right now, today.
So here's the big aha moment, the final takeaway. This model, it's not just looking at next year's profits. It's trying to suck in the value of all future profits, compounding on top of each other year after year, basically forever. And that is why just nudging that tiny G variable, that forever growth rate, has such an absolutely explosive impact on the price we see today.
So at the end of the day, it really all boils down to this one question. The next time you're looking at a stock, don't just focus on what it's earning right now. Instead, ask yourself this. What is the story about its future that the market is buying into? Because as we just saw with our own eyes, a tiny little change in that story can change absolutely everything.